guys. So I just got home. This morning I went out with Maggie because she needed to find a dress that she's gonna wear to her brother's graduation. And then she asked if I wanted to tag along, so I just went with her. I also picked up a card for Winston's graduation that we'll be going to. So it's just a Hallmark card. And it says, "Your future starts now," with wishing you much success and all the best. So I'm gonna write a little note for him. Also give this to Tiffany so that she can write something for him as well. And then yesterday I went for a walk with Kush, and we stopped by 7-Eleven because I've been wanting to find this poppy. Like, it's been everywhere on TikTok and I finally found it, so I kind of wanted to share with you guys. But it's the poppy, like, huge can version of the wild berry, which is a limited, I think, like, flavor only found at 7-Eleven. So I was really excited that I saw them. I got my sister one. She's trying it right now. I give it a 10 out of 10. It's a little sweeter than the other poppies, but I really like the flavor. And I also am a big fan of the color of the can. So if you guys have the chance to stop into a 7-Eleven, try to find this tomorrow. The Bridgerton trailer for season 3 is coming out. And let me tell you, Tiffany and I are going to be on that as soon as possible. I wanted to do like a reaction video with her, but I don't think she will probably like wait for me. She like knows exactly what time it's coming out because this TikTok live, I think, is also going on. So I'm going to try to do like a short reaction for you guys. Tiffany's an extreme fan of the Bridgerton universe, and like, I truly didn't even remember them doing PR for season 2 when it came out because I was in didactic year, and I literally, like, that time I was in the trenches. I think the next season's coming out in about a month's time, so we're both just like excited to see any new content from them. I will include those clips of me reacting when I actually watch the trailer. Good afternoon, guys. I forgot to film this morning, but Tiffany and I did a quick like reaction to the Bridgerton season 3 trailer. So if you want to see that, then keep watching. If you don't, you can skip until like this next part of the vlog. But it was really exciting because Tiffany and I are just really excited for the new season. I think it's a season that we can, or I would say like I can sort of relate to, because Penelope is a wallflower, and so she just, it's like a little more relatable than the other seasons, if that makes sense. If you guys are also excited for the new season, let us know in the comments. We would love to converse with you guys about this just because we adore the show a lot, and Tiffany has read literally all the books, so she knows all the details inside and out. Yeah, just let us know if you're excited because we want to know that we're not the only people. Are you ready? Oh, say hi.
Hi.
I'm gonna make it full screen. Are you ready, Tiffany? Okay.
Dearest gentle reader, we have been apart for far too long. At last, London's fashionable set has made its return. And it seems that our bon ton is moving with the changing tide. So too is this author.
I cannot live at home any longer. Let us take a husband.
Does my lady have a suitor in mind?
Is that her brother?
Colin?
Brother, under what foreign sun did you apparently get so sturdy?
Oh, well, it's good to see you.
Is it?
Something wrong?
Seems as though every Bridgerton was born to attract notice. For some of us, notice is very slight.
If a husband is what you seek, let me help you. Are we not friends?
Friends.
I should like to see your skills as they are first.
How delightful to see you all. The splendid weather we are having.
There's for her.
I would not be angry if you found me to be a lost cause.
You must not say such things. You are Penelope Featherington. Do not forget that.
She's not seeking a husband in you, I hope.
No, I'm only helping her find one.
Since when are you worried about Penelope?
What this author knows to be true is that diamonds are not the only gems that sparkle. Lord Debling.
Oh, he is eager to take a wife this season.
You look especially beautiful tonight, Miss Featherington.
You have done very well, Penelope.
What more could you want?
Mother, do you believe the best foundation for love is friendship?
It is rare, but you must follow your heart. What is the primary force that guides us along our paths?
Penelope.
Is it our minds or our hearts?
I mean, do you see the smoke in the background? Like, what the fuck?
Is it our minds or our hearts?
Oh, wait. Something burned down.
No, but there's smoke. No, but there's, like, smoke coming from the ground and everything. Like, a smoke machine. Like, I feel like this is supposed to be, like, a fantasy. I don't know. Who knows? No one knows. Can we go back to Lady Danbury telling Penelope, like, oh, this is Lord Debling. He's looking to find a wife. Is she talking to Penelope? I can't remember. No, that's not Penelope. I don't know who that is.
Oh, this is the queen, isn't it?
Okay, play it.
Like, there's like the people in the back.
Yeah. Wait, play it.
Lord Debling. He is eager to take a wife this season.
You look especially beautiful tonight, Miss Featherington.
Say that again?
The one where they're dancing together, do you see how, like, there's like, guards and everyone at the top? The one where he's like, you look especially beautiful tonight.
Then
he's this? Not this one before. No, the one before it.
Oh my god,
why wife this season?
You look especially...
Oh, up here. This is the Queen's Ball.
It's some... ball hosted by the queen, probably, because why is she all the way up top? Oh, I mean, she's not there, but, like, you know, like, the royal guards. Oh my god,
you know, when she, like, walked down the steps, it kind of reminded me of the Cinderella one.
Yeah,
the Cinderella movie with Hilary Duff.
Oh, okay, the one with the masks.
Yeah.
Oh,
wait, my this god. Is so crazy.
Wait, did you? I think it's so cute. I don't know if you noticed, because, like, when everyone turned around to look at her, Albion Finch, like, Philippa's husband.
They're smiling.
Smiley. He's, like, one of the only ones who smiled. He's such a good brother-in-law.
I know. Also, but you saw the part with the new dude who plays...
Marcus Anderson?
No, the who... His name is James Foon?
Dankworth.
Yeah, did you see the part when they were, like, dangling the berries?
So cute.
Oh my gosh.
I'm laughing because I'm like, oh my god, Philippa really married someone that she could boss around for the rest of her life.
I think he's changing. I think he comes back and they're like, we have to go to a thing. And he's changing in the carriage.
You're right. Oh my god.
Yeah, because... in the beginning, like, when all the family's like, Colin, they're all dressed up going somewhere.
Oh my god. Brittany! You genius!
Holy shit. That's why he's changing the build of the carriage. Or they're going here, or I don't know. But they're going somewhere.
Yeah, no, they're going somewhere. No, this is the Hartfield balloon thingy that we saw in the still that they released today.
But that means that Debling is here too.
Yeah.
So Debling meets Penelope before the ball?
Well, we don't know, because I don't know. I don't think so. I think he's just introduced to us, like, and then we see that he kind of will notice Penelope standing by herself, like, at the edge of the ballroom, things like that.
and
this is so funny. Can't wait.
Wait, I'll be right back. I have to check on my stones.
Okay.
All right. Good morning, everyone. I am getting ready to head out. This is probably the worst angle I could have put you at, but I wanted to do a quick haul of the things that I wanted to bring to the thrift store today. I'm gonna pick up Tiffany later. We are going to go to Plato's Closet, and my plan, just so I remember what I am bringing to the thrift store, I'm gonna show you guys quickly, because I already folded everything. A pair of Tommy Hilfiger jeans, a Champion gray hoodie, pair of Tommy Hilfiger shorts. I'm not really sure the brand of this, but it's like an overall, these long overalls. A pair of vintage Levi's. These were my mom's when she was younger. I wish I was as skinny as my mom when she was younger, because I would definitely wear these, but they just don't fit me, so I'm going to give them away. And then this is like a army green skinny jean pant kind of thing with slits on the knees. They just don't fit me as well as they used to, and so that's why I'm giving them away. This is a Forever 21 black blazer. This is a cocktail dress that my mom bought a long time ago, and she just doesn't wear it anymore, so we're giving that away. This is a Uniqlo dress pant. This is a Forever 21 corduroy skirt, and then also another Uniqlo dress pant. I do have more downstairs, so I'm just gonna head down in a little bit and I'll show you guys the rest of what I'm bringing. All right, so I'm gonna bring all this down in a bag, but the bag is not big enough, so we gotta find another one. And I'm just gonna show you the rest of the things that I'm gonna give away right now so that I can pack them all together. Another thing I'm giving away is this Calvin Klein hoodie. I'm also trying to sell this Aeropostale muscle tank. It's really cute. I just don't wear that kind of stuff, so it's like not for me anymore. This is my sister's Hollister. It's like a white dress, sundress. It's really cute, honestly. This is a H&M romper. There is a, what is this? Zara bomber jacket, Brandy Melville tank top, an Old Navy denim shirt. This is an H&M tank top. Oh, it's like a Forever 21 bomber jacket kind of thing. This is a Brandy Melville off the shoulder black top. It's a Old Navy sundress, very cute. And they're also, I think the store is looking more for dresses and sundresses for the summer, so this is a good piece, honestly. This is a blouse from Old Navy. This is a tank top from Old Navy. And lastly, a pair of linen blue pants from Forever 21. We're at the store. It's on the ground, so they said it's gonna be an hour and 15 minutes, so we're just gonna look around the store for things. Alright guys, so just to recap on the whole thrifting, selling experience, I think I brought like almost 20 things. I don't know if I counted everything, but they ultimately took 5 things for me. It was the Levi's, the overalls, my Tommy Hilfiger shorts, the Hollister like white sundress, and then the Zara bomber jacket. And so they gave me like $21, which is not, that's not like amazing, but it's also not terrible, and since this is stuff that I'm never gonna wear again, it's better than nothing, so it's okay that they didn't give me more. But I did end up buying one shirt, and it was on clearance, and they were having 70% off the entire like clearance section. So my shirt came out to like $280, which was honestly insane, because it is a Patagonia like t-shirt kind of thing. And I thought that this would be cute to wear if I was going on a hike or something, or like just to walk around at like a park or something. I was wearing biker shorts today because I went to the gym prior. So when I went into the changing room, it was like blue and black, and I really liked
the look of it. So this is the shirt that I got, and then on the back it's like the actual Patagonia logo. Now I'm just gonna go take a shower. I'm also going to include the clips that Tiffany sent me of the clothes that she got. She definitely got more than me. I think it was like 2 or 3 items. So I'll let you see what that is. And then also recently I've been doing my nails a lot, especially with gel. And so they've been not that great and healthy. And Tiffany actually introduced this to me, this product called OPI Repair Mode. It's supposed to strengthen your nails, and I haven't tried it yet, but every day I've been putting cuticle oil on my nails, and I'm hoping that it just like makes them stronger and healthier. So we'll see how that goes. I will let you know if I have any updates on that.
Okay, hello. Brittany wants me to do like a mini haul of everything that I got from Plato's Closet. So here it is. I got 3 items in total. Brittany got like 1 item, I think. She got like a shirt, which she'll probably show you if you haven't. Yeah, anyway. So I got these pants. They're from Madewell. It's a pair of jeans. They're like skinny jeans, I think. No, that's a lie. I do have a pair of skinny jeans. Okay, whatever. But I don't wear them often because most of my other jeans are like flare pants. They're not bell bottoms. I don't know, whatever. So they flare out at the bottom, which is what I usually like. But I decided to try these on and they actually fit quite well. So this is what they look like. This is so bad. It's like this. And then the other thing that I got is this top, actually the whole outfit that I'm wearing right now because I'm trying it on. So this is the top. It is a Halara top. It's padded. It's supposed to be an exercise top, but I figured it looks just as nice outside of exercise. Brittany found this top for me actually, and she told me to try it on, and it actually fits really well, so I kept it. Okay, so the other pair of pants is this. Ta-da! It's like patchwork denim, which I think is so cute. It's my first pair of pants that looks like that. And then if you look in the back, oh my god, my vanity is so messy. Look, you can see the little pocket. It's a different kind of denim. Right there. It's so cute. Anyways, so that's it. The 3 items. Oh, this pair of jeans is from Hollister. And that's it. That's the haul. Bye.
Hi, everyone. So I just got back from the gym. I didn't eat enough this morning because after the gym, I felt really, really lightheaded. And then I basically like didn't even have energy to get out of the car, but I was starving, so I forced myself to get back in here and eat, and I just finished eating. But because I did weights today, I decided I wanted to make a protein smoothie. So if you watched my previous vlog, you'll know that I was talking about like this specific type of protein powder that I wanted to try because I finished my Orgain one. So I actually got it. It's the Garden of Life one. I usually like chocolate flavored protein powder, but they didn't have that, so I just got the vanilla. And we are going to try this protein powder out, and I'm going to give you a review of what I think about it right now. All right, so to go over the ingredients, obviously I'm going to need the protein powder. I'm going to be using mango chunks, blueberries, some milk. This is lactose-free milk. And then I'm also going to use half a banana. This one's not frozen, but I would usually use a frozen one. And I'm actually going to use half because this banana is super long. Like, I don't know why. All right, so I just finished blending the smoothie. I'm going to take the cap off. Okay, I definitely taste the protein. It's not bad. I would say that there's a very distinct taste to it. I'm not really sure how I would describe it just yet, but it's too early for me to say if I like this one better or the Orgain one. So I'll have to try it like another time when I don't have as many fruits and things in the smoothie. All right, so I just got home. I was going to vlog more today, but I ended up not because Tiffany and I will be vlogging more when we hang out with Winston in a couple of weeks. So you guys stay tuned for that. But that's gonna be the end for this vlog. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.